One side chosen for their skills in deception, manipulation, and duplicity. The villains.
I mean, is that kosher? There's so many men on this tribe now. It seems like we got all the, like, really big buff guys. I'm absolutely gonna flirt with them. Get them on my good side. It's what I do best. I'm a little baby monkey.
Yeah, Mo, your baby monkey.
I already had Adam from the beginning.
Poverty on the pole.
You have water in there?
I was drawn to Nate in the first place just because he's so, like, outgoing and funny and kind of charming. So I decided to work him, just for starters.
I think Poverty feels really safe because the guys love her. She's, you know, a happy-go-lucky, young, adorable girl. And I don't think they want to see her go at all. She's entertainment for them. You know, it's like watching a movie to them, sitting around and letting her be adorable.
Bums away.
Okay, Mama, you do that one more time and come up there.
When I first saw Poverty, I was like, damn.
Poverty now on her second pole.
Boys will be boys, you know? There's nothing else going on this island. There's no music, no anything. So what else are they gonna think about? They're bored, you know?
She likes to put on her buff as a miniskirt. It's great scenery.
So I wanna get in tight with all the guys, work them and manipulate them and stuff like that. Like, I haven't even begun to work my feminine ways. It's all a game. The dating game, the game of survival, it's all the same. Have to figure out the best way to infiltrate the little groups.
Did y'all make a serious alliance? You guys?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, guys are tight. But you know, we're tighter than all that. I got your back. You know I got your back. You're not gonna get like scooped off. You know that. You don't believe me?
I believe you.
I know you believe me.
My feelings for Poverty are that she's a very cool girl. We click real good. She's smart, but I can definitely trust her. You know, she's definitely like, she's my ace right now.
They have no clue how tight you are.
I think there definitely could be some sparks in the future, but I don't want to find myself thinking like a dum-dum and just, you know, just guys, sometimes we can't control ourselves.
They trust me.
By the guys, you mean JP. He's the one who's calling the shots. He's the one who's making the decision.
Well, he is, because he knows he has me, and he knows he has the other guys.
I just don't like that he is, like, completely in control right now.
JP is very demanding, and I think he does it in a very sly way, where if you're not very observant, you wouldn't even realize that he's being controlling. But just the way he was sitting in camp today, like, all sprawled out with his back against the, like, recliner on the throne, and everyone's just, like, waiting on him.
Poverty came in the city.
Where is it? Oh, yeah. He's very demanding. He's like, oh, hand me that machete. Oh, hand me this bowl, you know, serve me. I'm like, no, that just doesn't fly with me at all.
JP, chop is spoken.
That was pretty good.
It's really funny. The guys have really stepped it up since JP's gone.
Unbelievable.
Nate did get a massive pile of wood this morning. I've never seen a pile of wood bigger than that. And Adam went and got like 5 crabs.
Wow.
And Brad went out and just went fishing. They're just so much more manly now that the top dog is gone. I think they're definitely trying to prove themselves to the women so that the women don't try to overthrow all the guys. I love it.
Do you want to stay in the game?
Yeah, I'm going to stay in the game.
Because, I don't know, it's just like, because some people are saying that you are saying, making comments that you want to go. Like you want to go home and, you know, eat mashed potatoes or something today.
It's amazing how one little thing could just be taken out of context, you know?
Everyone's trying to watch their own back right now. If you slip up and say something, they're going to use that and they're going to extort it and use it to their advantage.
Elder.
You have to really watch yourself.
Wow.
The only reason I switched was because Nate said that she was talking about, I wouldn't mind getting some mashed potatoes or something like that.
No. I don't think she said that.
She doesn't want to go. I don't think she wants to go. I'm voting my conscience.
Stephanie, tribe has spoken.
You pissed everyone in this game off. So, hope you're happy with second place. I just think that you played yourself out tonight, and I'm so disappointed. It's vile to me. It makes me, I feel sick to my stomach. After Tribal, I just felt like this nausea, and I really, all I wanted to do was take Jonathan's face and just throw up all over it.
It's not fun.
Kind of grosses me out, but I'm gonna watch.
Yeah, you reach inside and you just pull out.
Ew.
I'm guessing this is day 28. Parvati had never gutted a fish or even seen how to gut a fish in 28 days out here. Now, I don't know how that's possible.
What is that thing?
Esophagus.
Oh, and you guys eat that. Candace eats it.
She's a lazy, selfish girl. And $1 million to her would not help her in her life. It would screw her life up.
I want to punch him in the mouth. I'm half his age, and I'm twice as mature as he is.
Sold for $360 for Parvati.
Oh, man.
$360, take your cake. Bath is yours.
Wow, that's huge.
She's in her element, you see. She's happy.
I love this day. It's my favorite day. Oh, I'd say I bonded with the fellas.
Noxious. I would hate to see Jonathan in the final four.
Does this make you guys want to reconsider the order?
So, exposed. A little cliff, perhaps.
What's that?
Everyone's pissed off about what Jonathan's display today. With the challenge, how, like, cocky and arrogant he was. I was just like, maybe there's a little resentment, a little hostility brewing.
I just figure, like, today's show was very
revealing.
Very revealing. I think that we were all surprised. That was the first thing on people's minds when we came back. I think his true personality is finally coming out.
And if he gets to the final four, I will shoot myself. Potentially, this game could get flipped on top of its head once more. I'm hoping and praying. It all hangs on other people right now. So the best I can do is try to be as persuasive as I can and try not to be pushy.
Oh, oh my gosh.
What do I do?
That is a deep cut. That's a really deep
cut. Pressure?
Yeah. Do we have, where's your buff? We have to have somebody look at it because that looks too deep.
I feel like my finger's about to fall off.
Yeah.
Oh, I got so tight.
There's a slice through the nail, pretty close to the middle of the nail, so we try to stay as calm as possible to keep her calm.
We have a little issue, guys, with our dear Parvati. She kind of sliced her thumb in half trying to open up a coconut. Yeah.
I think that Parvati needs medical attention. It's like literally you can see where it's separated, where the finger is actually separated.
Huh. We're going to have a bit of a look at it here and then see what we need to do. How did this happen?
I was chopping a coconut with a machete and I chopped up my finger instead.
Good news is you're not going to need to trim your thumbnail for a while.
Thumbs up.
Let's talk about Exile Island. Parvati, why Jonathan?
Sending Jonathan was a strategy move to keep myself in the game as long as possible. I'm hoping that they'll begin to see, you know, life is better without him and keep me and Adam.
Jonathan, tribe has spoken.
Really frustrating for me because I'm on the outside. I don't know what to do. I think the only thing that I can do now is try pulling someone over to my side and making them play a strategic game. And really, I mean, I think Ozzy would be my only hope.
Poverty inches her way onto the next pole.
The more charming that I can be, the more, like, friendly and in that I can get with these people, especially Ozzy, the longer I'm going to stick around.
Poverty, the tribe has spoken. Time for the go.
I just peed in my pants, and I wasn't even wearing any.